Hi everyone, welcome back to the Intro to USD Workflow series. In the last tutorial, we explored layout and assembly using this cyber district as an example. Today we'll dive into referencing and editing animations, as well as setting up a camera for the shot. Let's get started. For this demo, I prepared a dancing robot, which I'll reference into the scene. I generated this animation using Wonder Studio, an AI tool by Wonder Dynamics, an Autodesk company. The process of making it is both enjoyable and intuitive. I recorded myself dancing, uploaded the video, assigned a character, and selected the output formats. One of my outputs was a Maya scene, which I'll use for this demo. You can choose the output format based on the software you use. After it finished processing, I got my dancing robot, which is fully editable. Click the link in the description to learn more about Wonder Studio. Now back in Maya, I'll unlock and target the animation layer, because that's where we want to store the animation data. Then I'll lock the layout layer to prevent any unintended changes. Before I reference the animation, I want to switch the purpose from render to proxy in the attribute editor so it runs faster. Now I'll create an XForm prim as a container for the animated robot. Right-click at the root prim district. Select Add New Prim, XForm. I'll rename it Robot. To reference a Maya animation, right-click, select Add Maya Reference. I'll select the animation I created using Wonder Studio. Here I'll rename the Maya Reference prim to Robot Animation. And click Reference. Now we have the robot in the scene. What you see here is the view from the camera included in the file exported from Wonder Studio. It also contained a light, which I removed just to simplify the scene for this tutorial. Here you can see we have referenced both the character and the camera. For this demo, I'll unload this camera, because later I'll show how to create a camera in USD. To unload a reference, go to File, Reference Editor. Right-click at the camera, under Reference, select Unload Reference. Now I'll switch back to the perspective view. Select the robot and adjust its scale and location. I'll place it in front of the music store and rotate it. This is what the animation looks like inside the cyber district. It may need some minor adjustments, which I'll cover in a later tutorial. Now let's see how to edit a reference Maya animation in USD. To enable editing a referenced animation, go to Windows, select Preferences. Under File References, make sure that the first option, Allow Edits on Referenced Animation Curves, is selected. To demo the animation editing, I'll select this skeleton and open the graph editor by selecting Windows, Animation Editors, Graph Editor. Here I can select the curves, optimizing the rotations using the Euler filter. I can also smooth the curves using the Smooth filter. Once we're satisfied with the result, we can cache the Maya animation to USD data. To do that, simply right-click at the referenced animation, select Cache USD. Here you can adjust the settings. For example, if I expand animation, I can set the frame range for caching. Let's say from frame 36 to the last frame 461. Name the output USD file and click Cache. This saved the animation data to the designated USD file. After it finishes caching, you'll see in the outliner the prim robot has become a variant set, which contains two variants, the cache animation and the Maya reference. If you want to do more editing, you can switch back to the Maya reference, edit it, and cache it again. I'm good with this animation, so I'll switch back to the cache and save the animation layer. Now I'm ready to add the camera for this shot. Usually cameras are added to the layout layer, so let's unlock and target the layout layer. We also want to lock the animation layer. You can just click the lock icon. But today I want to show a different way of locking a layer, which is system lock. This method is often used by TD to make a layer read-only, preventing accidental edits by other users. You can use either MAL or Python script to system lock a layer. To demonstrate, I'll use a MAL script in the script editor. This is the command for layer locking. The first argument specifies the lock type. 2 is for system lock. And the second argument defines whether to include sublayers. 0 means excluding sublayers. Then we provide the paths for the Maya proxy shape and the layer to lock. Execute the command and it system locks the animation layer. To unlock a system locked layer, we use the same command. Just change the first argument to 0. I'll relock this layer. And I'll also system lock the root layer. For more information on layer locking, click the link in the description to access the MyUSD documentation. Now let's add the camera. Right-click on the root prim. Under Add New Prim, All Registered, Geometry, select Camera. Now we see the camera in the scene. We can animate a USD camera by editing it as Maya data. To do that, right-click and select Edit as Maya data. Let's switch to this camera's view and adjust the perspective. I'll set a keyframe at frame 0, then scroll to about the midpoint of the timeline. Adjust the camera position and keyframe it again. Similarly, I'll move to the last frame, adjust the camera, and add one more keyframe. If I play the animation, you'll see a smooth transition in the camera view. Now I can merge the Maya edits back to USD. Right-click, and you'll see this option, Merge Maya Edits to USD. Let's select the camera view. And here's the animated USD camera. I'll switch to Render Purpose to view the result. That's how you can create an animated character and camera in a USD stage. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I'll see you next time.